Coming up on this majestic stage in a matter of moments, we will be making history. The first event of its ever kind on planet Earth. The first USA Mullet Championships live event is taking place here in the spiritual home of competitive mulletry, Fitz Casino and Hotel. These contestants are making history, and you are here to witness it. Ladies and gentlemen, give yourselves a round of applause before you clap for anybody else. At USA Mullet Championship, we believe that the mullet is more than a hairstyle, for it is a lifestyle. And it stands at the core of the American experience, and we are here to mark its place in our culture. Ladies and gentlemen, we are the official ranking authority of the business in the front, the party in the back, lifestyle and hairstyle. We will be judging mullets today by four criteria. I'll soon be joined by three professional judges to mark our contestants. The first round, mullet at first sight. When they take the stage, you want to see the power of the mullet spirit, the mullet confidence, the mullet pride. It is no different than seeing a mullet in the wild. You know if the hair and the person owning the hair has it within themselves. Round two, mullet metrics, where we get into the science of the mullet. How business is the front? How much do you want to party with the back? It is not just about length. It is about your desire to party with that back flow. How do the sides work? And what is the age of the mullet? Because at USA Mullet Championships, we believe in vintage and commitment to the mullet lifestyle. Round three, the mullet mantra. Our contestants have been asked to recite a mission statement, if you will, or their mantra of what their mullet means to them. If this was the Miss USA Championship, and I asked Miss USA how to defeat inflation or lower gas prices, and they would have to come up with something that spoke to the spirituality of the American experience and also economic rationale. It's like that, but about mullets, so it's better. Round four, ladies and gentlemen, the crescendo of proceedings, the mullet shake. Our contestants will all be asked to come to the front of the stage and perform the mullet shake, ladies and gentlemen. The mullet shake is the most beautiful thing when seen in the wild. Aficionados compare it to a stallion raising upon his hind legs to better display his power and beauty. That is what is going to happen here today. At the conclusion of the individual mullet shakes, for the first time in human history, all the mullets will stand in line and free shake, much like at a bodybuilding tournament, where there's a massive pose-off, where everybody's showing you their specific parts of their anatomy, but there are no lime green speedos on my stage, I promise you that. Oh, that is just how it's gonna work, okay? My apologies. What is at stake? Why do we do this? The winner here today, ladies and gentlemen, earns a top 25 ranking and immediate placement in the main event, MAME. Get it? At the USA Mullet Championships season finale later this year. $1,000 prize purse on the line here today, $500 to first place, $300 to second, $200 to third, along with a fetching pair of Pit Viper sunglasses, ladies and gentlemen. But let us be honest, first, second, third, that is all great. But all of our contestants here today are all winners, because they will make history here today, and they all have mullets. So I like them very, very much. Now, I'm gonna do the big introduction, the big bombastic introduction that is going to blow your mind and it's gonna get your goosebumps absolutely soaring. Ladies and gentlemen of Tunica, Mississippi and the world, walk with me into a better and brighter future. For here, in this august ballroom, we await the swing sword of justice wielded by the Almighty. Wielded to behead the weak and to raise up the pure of mullet, ladies and gentlemen. Now is the hour when glory calls and only the bravest are left standing to answer. For this is the USA Mullet Championship at Fitz Casino and Hotel. Forwards! The sweetest four in the English language. Let the contest begin!
Woo! 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 You go, Sam! Sam to them!
Let the contest begin, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's meet our judges, shall we? Our first judge is a men's haircutting specialist from Louisville, Kentucky. Last summer, her 5-year-old rocked a mullet all season long. She is to get married next month, but today she only has eyes for mullets. Please welcome Jess Breeden! Our next judge is the president and CEO of the Tunica Convention and Visitors Bureau. He is a member of both the Mississippi and Tunica Tourism Halls of Fame, the man who put Tunica on the map. Think Tunica, you think of Webster Franklin. Our final judge sculpts mullets at 1776 Men's Grooming Parlor in Collierville, Tennessee. Her first crush was Billy Ray. I got that wrong.
What the?
Please welcome Rachel White.
Woo!
Mullets, when you hear your name, you have 20 seconds to impress. Get with the impressing stat. Are you guys ready to do this? Mullets, backstage, are you ready?
Yes.
George Washington was the first president of the United States. Our first contestant is the first human being to set foot at a live USA Mullet Championships live event. This gentleman, however, has much better hair than the first president from Nashville, Tennessee. Give it up for Chad Beck.
In Arizona, so this is the Arizona waterfall.
Arizona waterfall, ladies and gentlemen! This past Valentine's Day, our next contestant wrote the following poem and delivered it to his loved one. Roses are red, violets are blue, sugar is sweet, and so is my mullet. From Conway, Arkansas, low and round! Our next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, is 21 years age and stands at the crossroads of life. So many choices to make. Family, career, work, love. And he has decided to take this opportunity to stand before you all to declare that he has decided to dedicate his life to something with purpose, something with meaning, his mullet. Please welcome, from Harlem, Georgia, the great Dan Hamilton!
No.
It's the coon dog! Yeah, Our next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, is the quiet man of competitive mulletry. Seriously, you ask him simple questions like, hey man, how you been? And he just points at the mullet. It's kind of weird, but it's also very awesome. From Montgomery, Alabama, give it up for Christopher Jarrett! What is that thing?
Scooter.
It's the scooter, ladies and gentlemen. Our next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, is a musician by trade, a mullet by disposition. From Nashville, give it up for Andrew Highlander. Now we're going to go on to our mullet metrics, ladies and gentlemen. Our mullet metrics, for me to judge the business at the front, the party in the back, the sides, and the vintage flow of mullet! Chad, to the front of the stage. Let's inspect over the next 30 seconds. Thursday was the last time it was cut. Judges, let's inspect. Is this natural? Yes. Now to the stage, Daniel Hamilton, please. Judges, let us inspect. Rachel's bringing out the tape measure. I like what I'm seeing here.
Audience, on three, give me your best born to rock.
One, two, three.
Born to rock.
This gentleman is not being called. He's Chris Jackson. By land, I should say. Judges, inspect the mullet of the Highlander. From the north lands of Scotland. Rachel, what are you seeing here?
I'm seeing a lot of
kneecaps. Tucker, ladies and gentlemen. The OG mullet, 37 years of American freedom on one man's head. Can't do this in Russia. Save the world, the role of the mullet in inflationary policy, things like that. As I said earlier, if this was Miss World or Miss USA Championship, we were asking about world peace. Today we're going to ask about mullets. It's far more important than peace. I think we can all agree on that. The experience of having your mullet judged with such precision, was it awkward in any way?
Not at all. The beautiful part about the mullet is its ability to adapt in stressful situations. Even under the scrutiny of professionals, it still flows like a river, baby.
Chris, you go to the next round late. I would ask you to take a seat. If we have anybody here who's in any English departments at any local university, I would urge you to burn the works of Keats, Yeats, Wordsworth, et al. And get Jack, Christopher on the books. I now call upon Chad Beck to deliver his remarks. Mr. Beck.
How you guys doing out there?
Great.
Oh.
Wow, that's not very
kidding.
Having a mullet makes a man trustworthy. You know when you see a man, you can trust that he will get the party started. And that party will keep going as long as his hair is flowing.
Woo!
Chad, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome to the stage, Lauren Bryan, to deliver his mullet
second.
I think mullets are all about a sense of community. Without ever saying a word, I can identify all these like-minded individuals and find companions with them. And we look good doing it, don't we?
Yeah.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, we've got to be bringing the world together. Let's hear from John Van Balen, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, John.
Wearing a mullet and growing it out stamps you as a wild card. It lets people know from a football field away that you're capable of anything. And let me tell you, I'd rather eat my own nose than get rid of all this.
I'm not new to this mullet, I'm true to this mullet. Just take my breath away. Next up, mullet spirit, let's hear from Daniel Hamilton, ladies and gentlemen.
How's everybody doing? I gotta say, it is an honor to be here. I mean, having a mullet is so cool, but I mean, hey, it keeps your neck from getting burnt when you're out on the lake or something. So I mean, mullets are just awesome, man. You can't go wrong with them. You gotta keep the river flowing, like my buddy said over here, man.
Thank you, Daniel.
Now let us hear from the mullet poet laureate himself, Christopher Jarrett.
Alright, so I want to start off by saying thank you to my competitors. I get to be the rookie of this event with a less than a year old mullet, but from the beginning of the foundation of our country, America's been filled with people that are willing to break rules and make different decisions. I think the mullet amplifies and quantifies that, both as the ability to say business in the front, I'm ready to get the job done, but man, we got a party, bro, we're doing it!
Christopher Jarrett, ladies and gentlemen.
Where's the party job, baby?
Let's now hear from the great Andrew Highlander.
Oh,
the thing about mullet, that's the wrong part. So mullet is a power move. You walk in the room with a mullet, they know there's nothing they can do to them, or they can do to you, however, you know what I mean. I don't get embarrassed, I'm always proud. You see this? How can you get embarrassed with something like this, or any of these guys, really? Right? It's just a power move. You know, I walk in somewhere and it's automatic freedom everywhere I go. What does it say? Beer, bacon, and freedom.
Thank you, Andrew! Let's hear now from Micah Tucker.
Yes, sir, OG!
I don't really know what to say here because I had my cards all made up and they left them in the car, so. But, I don't know. I get my strength from my mullet. Jesus had long hair. I got long hair. I'm in it to win it.
And he walked everywhere he went.
Micah Tucker.
OG!
I now want to hear from Robert Smith and the role of Bert.
Come on, Bert.
So I like to be different, unique, stared at, gazed upon whenever I walk out in the crowd. And there's trends that happen every so often. And I thought, you know, this was about 10 years ago. Let's bring back the mullet. and so I started wearing one back then. I coined my own phrase, all business and no party makes a hashtag mullet man a dog guy.
Thank you very much, Robert. And finally, let's hear it from Matthew Ray.
Thank you, brother. I gotta tell you something. People die in the panhandle justice, but I'll tell you what, he's here now, and ain't nothing you can do about it. This mullet represents everything I am as a musician. I transcribe, and I'm able to convey everything and all this energy in this mullet into my drum kit. And I'm also able to sell some of the best high-quality Chicago hot dogs on the coast of Florida because of this mullet. It is me, it is my personality, it is everything about me. Panhandle justice come from you, and ain't nothing you can do about it, brother!
Thank you, Matthew. Thank you, Matthew.
Okay. Judges, I would ask you to tally your results. Keep working with Matthew. The next round, ladies and gentlemen, is the crescendo of proceedings. The mullet shake. As I said in my opening remarks, aficionados compare it to a stallion rising on his hindquarters to better display his power and beauty in the wild. An alpha move. Our contestants will have 20 seconds to shake it. After that, I will ask them to take their seat, immediately after which I will ask the next contestant to fill the void at the front of the stage. The mullet shaking void cannot last long. At the conclusion of which, we will have a free mullet shake, and that will end proceedings before the presentations. Before I do that, ladies and gentlemen, I do want to give some shout outs and thank yous. Thank you, of course, to our friends, Fitz Casino and Hotel. Without them, we would not be here. The preeminent gaming and entertainment destination in the region, state, nation, if not the world. Thank you to my right-hand women here at Fitz, the great Penny Franklin, ladies and gentlemen, the great Mary Beth Wilkes. Thank you so very much, Mary Beth and Penny. Thank you, of course, to Rebel Stoke. Rebel Stoke is the official whiskey partner of USA Mullet Championships. There is no better way to toast a beautiful mullet than with a glass of Rebel Stoke 21 and over.
Woo, Maris. Yes.
Thanks to each and every one of you for coming out. Thank you for bringing your energy, your passion, your mullet spirit. You may not have the mullets on your head right now, but you certainly have the spirit in your heart. I believe that your hair can follow, especially you, Liam. Just get a razor on that bad boy and set to go. And thanks, of course, to those mullets who can't be here today. Those mullets past. We follow in their footsteps with every passing day of growth. Thanks to all mullets present. We have 9 beautiful sons of 9 proud daughters. Proud mothers, that would be weird. On this stage. And thanks to mullets' future. Children right now. Probably not playing Little League, probably playing Fortnite. Dreaming of one day that they will join the stage at a USA Mullet Championships event. Thank you all, ladies and gentlemen. Judges, how are we doing?
America!
All right? America. All right? This is the crescendo. This is the mullet shake. There is no way to describe it other than to feel it. Chad, I'm going to give you the honor of taking the stage front and center right now. On 3, I will press. On 3, I will direct you because it does have a little intro. Chad, to the front of the stage. And on the beat, you have 20 seconds to impress the crowd and our judges. When the beat drops, go! John Van Balen!
Come on, John!
Oh, it's athletic! Look at the crowds! Look at the power! Hamilton, you know what you're doing, boy. Oh, he's got the horns up! He's got the horns up! The mullet shaker's shaking! Thank you so much, Daniel. Christopher Jarrett! Do your mullet shake! It would seem for the majority of our contestants. 20 minutes of moderate movement. Sorry, 20 seconds of moderate movement. But it's, you're not just, like I think, I mean, I can do cardio for 40 seconds, but I don't have a mullet. You have a mullet on, it cuts your cardio abilities in easily half, because you're doing the cardio for the mullet as well. And they say the human head weighs 8 pounds, but we weighed John Van Valen's head that day, didn't weigh 38 pounds. And 30 pounds of that was mullet. Right, so you're carrying some extra weight back there. So let's just, judge the cardiovascular abilities of our contestants. You guys have done the math? Do we have the combined scores?
Not yet.
Well, hang on. No, that's fine. You guys are doing great. We have some. This is like judging game show. Like they're telling you results. The energy is building in the room. You could cut it with a knife. Isaac, pay attention! The judges, all experts in the field of monetary, but also chartered accountants. Fact. I love the fan club. I love the fan club. Always good to see. Let's talk to some of our mods. Working now for another story. Who haven't I spoken to? To Andrew. Andrew, come with me. Now, Andrew, you have very powerful legs. Is it because of my hypothesis analysis? Is it the weight of the mullet that helps when you're doing your squats and your calf raises that it really helps you work out?
It's really more of the running, because this is like, once it starts flying, I go into like hyper speed.
Hyperspeed. How are you going to use your hyperspeed for good?
If we run out of beer, I can run to the store really bad. Because drinking and driving is bad.
Exactly, and it is. It absolutely is. I'm going to talk to. I'm going to talk to Robert Smith. Robert.
Come on, Bert.
What is the origin, because when I went through everybody's mullet's names, there were some many ones that impressed me highly. There were a couple that didn't disappoint me so much, but just didn't blow my mind.
and one sure above all. Bird. Because I didn't see that coming. Because if I did see it coming, I would be insane. Can you just give us the bird origin story?
Well, when signing up for the whole contest, I was going through address, city, state, and I get down to the last thing and it says, "What's your mullet name?" I've never named my mullet anything. And I'm like, what? All right, Bert, because it's the other portion of my name, Robert, Bert, so that's where it came from.
That's what it's supposed to be! Woo!
Yeah, I love it. Bert. Oh, no, it's spelled B-E-R-T. Yes. I should have put that there. Oh, yeah? Do you have any idea how to connect that? John Van Halen. Now, when I found out there was a man called John Van Halen competing, I was wondering if that was a play on John Van Halen, being dedicated to the, you know, obviously masters of 80s metal, very, you know, mullet-centric period of American history. John, is it Van Halen or Van Halen?
It's Van Halen, but I do get Van Halen by Jody and Hey You Big Guy sometimes.
Hey You Big Guy.
You know, if someone needs to know my blood type or whatever.
Okay, fair enough. A positive big guy. Now, John, look at the kicks, very athletic. I did see, when you were doing the mullet shake, I did see some very powerful hamstrings. And I know that you've obviously been keeping up with your jazzercise at the gymnasium. Do you work out in the tracksuit to help the sweating and to keep the weight down?
Not this particular windbreaker, but other ones I do wear, just to get my head in the right mindset.
To get your head in the right mindset. Thank you very much, John. Checking that judge is here. Thank you. The grand total, we are 1 minute away. Ladies and gentlemen. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah.
Stop shaking the table.
Matthew Ray, I would describe, upon meeting him and spending approximately an hour and a half with him, as we're here today, I would say he's an excitable man. He's a man of high energy, and he sells hot dogs. Where do you sell your hot dogs, Matthew?
So I sell them in Fort Walton Beach, Florida.
Fort Walton Beach, Florida. Next time you're in Fort Walton Beach, Florida, let's be clear. If you have a hankering for a hot dog, and why wouldn't you? I wake up thinking hot dog, I go to bed thinking hot dog. You're at Fort Walton Beach. You've got two choices. You can get a hot dog from someone without a mullet. Because that would be like, I've done that. I've had hot dogs. I've never had a hot dog grilled by someone called Panhandle Justice, but when you're at Fort Walton Beach next, go see Matthew Ray. He will hook you up.
All beef street meat, baby.
All beef street meat. 2 for 1, use the code Panhandle Justice.
I dare you to beat this beat.
It's very close.
I just heard from the judges, it's very close. Third place, ladies and gentlemen. $200 American and a pair of pit viper sunglasses. Second place, $300 and a pair of pit viper sunglasses. Thank you to our friends at Pit Viper for supplying these etching and scientifically proven shades. But first place, ladies and gentlemen, $500. I don't have it on me, it's coming right, check on Monday.
Alright, it's in, we're back.
Check the film. Check it out. Are we good? Are we square? Let me see.
I'm the smart one here. Check. Obviously. We're good. So, okay. So, this is one.
Ladies and gentlemen. In third place, if I call your name, I would ask you to stand up. In third place, $200 richer, out of a possible score of 300, he scores
1961, John Van Balen, ladies and gentlemen.
John Van Balen. Woo, John. Well done, John.
Woo. In second place, $300 richer. Give it up for Bert. With the money, because I said we're going to set up my check. A pair of pit viper sunglasses, but more importantly, a ranking in the top 25 of USA Mullet Championships and entry into the main event later this year. It is my honor and privilege to announce the winner of the first ever USA Mullet Championships live in person event here at Fitz Casino and Hotel. Your winner, Tunica! Thank you to Fitz Casino and Hotel. Be sure to stick around. Wine, dine, game with delight. Thank you to our friends at Rebel Soap. Thank you to all our contestants. A round of applause for all our contestants. Woo! Woo!
I think y'all know what time it is.
You did great, man. That's awesome. Dude, you got a great mullet, man. So don't ever live that down, man. That's a great mullet.
Thank you.
You're welcome.